Beginning Thursday, Oahu's stay-at-home order will be extended for 2 more weeks through September 23rd. This means that non-essential businesses like retailers, salons, and gyms will remain closed, and restaurants can only offer takeout. Any type of social gathering is still also prohibited. Filipino frontliners here are welcoming the extended safety measures.
I find that most people take this seriously when they know somebody who is affected or they have a family member who's directly affected. Here in Hawaii, we have to treat everybody as our family. We have to not be selfish and think about everybody else in the household.
On Wednesday, Hawaii Department of Health officials reported 3 more COVID-19 deaths on Oahu and 100 new infections statewide. Since the start of the pandemic, Hawaii has reported more than 10,100 cases with at least 91 deaths. Hawaii Governor David Ige said more work needs to be done to flatten the curve in the Aloha State. And for frontliners, it starts with a commitment to follow rules.
People stop listening to those rules. People get together in big groups. People stop wearing their masks. People stop, social distancing.
Under the new order, individual activities at parks and beaches like walking, jogging, lounging, sunbathing, and fishing are allowed. Honolulu Mayor Kirk Caldwell said that reopening the economy will be more cautious and conservative this time around to prevent another spike in COVID-19 cases.
Well, all it takes is for one person to bring it home, and because, a lot of people live in the same home, there's no way for anyone to quarantine, then it spreads.
Officials called Oahu's second shutdown a necessary sacrifice to protect public health. But the new order has been met with opposition from small business owners who have been hit hard by pandemic restrictions. Lelaine Ignau, ABS-CBN News, Honolulu, Hawaii.